If you're watching this video right now, that probably means that you want to learn how to play Karuta, or your friend wants you to learn, but are too lazy to teach you. So they sent me. Well, sit tight, because I'm about to teach you how to play the Karuta bot in less than 5 minutes. Karuta is an addictive card trading game at its heart. Everything is centered around building a solid collection. You can customize your cards, upgrade them to mint condition, and trade, and then pray that one day you will be blessed by the Karuta overlords that you will drop a mint condition ED3 Gojo. Now, before anything else, you must remember that the command for this bot is the letter K. So when you have a server with it, type the letter K before everything, and you start by simply dropping cards. K-drop or KD is the command for that. You can drop cards every 30 minutes, and you can pick up cards every 10 minutes. Some people pay to drop more cards, and some people pay to have a shorter cooldown, but let's not think about that. As stated, when you drop, 3 cards will appear, and it's up to you to pick the one that you want by reacting. Click the number you want. First card is 1, second one is 2, third is 3, easy peasy, simple as that. But once you drop, those cards are open for everyone to grab. Yes, everyone. It does have dropper priority, but if it's a server drop, it's up for anyone to grab. Now, when you grab a card, you will see the unique card code and the condition it dropped in. If you want to take a closer look at the card, you can type in KV or KView to take a closer look at it. Now, these are the parts of the card to remember. You know how the mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell? Well, the card code is the powerhouse of a card. The unique card code, if you ever want to do anything with this JPEG image of a card, you will have to use the numbers and letters here every single time. You want to give the card to someone, KGive, user, card code. You want to burn it, KBurn, card code. You want to frame it, K, use, frame, card code. Very important. Every card code is unique. That is your card. That is your card code. And from the card code, we now have the card condition. There are 5 different status conditions that your card can drop in: damaged, poor, good, excellent, and mint. You'll easily know the card status based off of how many stars that show up on your card. 0 being damaged, 5 being mint. And as you can see, the damaged cards look ugly. So when you type K upgrade, you will see that upgrades cost both dust and gold. So how does one get both dust and gold? You have to burn your cards. Yes, you must burn the waifus. If you burn a card that's in excellent condition, it will give you excellent dust, as well as some gold each time. Now, there are so many cards in the world of anime, so many characters, some that are easily burnable. Goodbye, Vanilla the Rabbit from Sonic X. Goodbye, Llama-san from Anime Capybara-san. And boom, we have dust. Let's upgrade this card. Fuck. So from card codes to condition, you will also see the print number. This isn't really important unless you get a print below 1000. If you get Hisoka from Hunter x Hunter's 44th print, you are lucky! So many people would want that card, and you can sell it for a lot, let me tell you. But just keep low and mid print cards in the back of your mind, because on top of trading, you can buy and sell cards. But we're not talking about that. Anyway, after the print number, you will see the card edition. You can tell these differences visually. You will see that it's either plain, gold, or in neat casing. And finally, we get the series and the character name of the card you just got. We now know every part to a card in this game. Card code, condition, print number, edition, series, and character. And there are so many cards in this game, it never fails to surprise me. If you want to see if Karuta has a specific character you want, you can type in KLOOKUP or KLU followed by the character name or series to see if they have it. But if you don't know what character you picked up, looking it up definitely helps when deciding whether to burn it, keep it, or me even making a trade for it. Let's see, looking up Eren Jaeger, 4,000 people want him. Therefore, you probably want to keep him, even if you don't really like Attack on Titan. And then say you drop Kamaji from Spirited Away, the iconic spider guy. You'll only see that 23 people want him. So is it worth keeping? Do you really like Spirited Away? Let's see how others feel about it. To get a closer look at the information about a card and specific character, just type the number that corresponds to it. So KLU Spirited Away, we see that it's number 6, type in 6, boom. You can see how many people tend to pick up the card, how many usually burn it after picking it up, all of those statistics. If you would like to see how many cards you have, what cards you own, type in KC or K Collection, and the bot will show you your cards from what you grabbed last. To organize it a bit, there is a sorting system, and you can type KC space O colon W, or K Collection, Organize, Wishlist. But that's too much to type, so KCOW is the easiest way. And boom, most wanted to least wanted cards. So here you can see which ones you want to keep and which ones you might want to burn. For burning purposes, you could also organize by quality on top of wish lists. Yes, the card condition, you can organize by that. So just type KCOW Q:Mint, or K Collection Organize Wishlist Quality Mint, but that's so much to type. And boom, there it is. It only shows you your cards that are mint, sorted by the most number of wishlists it has. Easy peasy. Another question, why do we have gold? Well, other than for upgrading, there are also shops in this game. But first, let's see what you already have. To see everything in your inventory, what do you think we type? I hope you said KI, because that is K inventory. You will see how much gold you have, how much dust, and if you want more, just type in K shop, and it'll show you a whole store. You can buy a trade license, albums, work permits. You can even buy more dust, because trust me, if you really want your waifu to get to mint, you will visit this shop often. Now, for beginners, I really want you to concentrate on just picking up cards. Grab and drop as many times as you can, burn your cards, get gold, and one day, get a work permit. What's a work permit? Well, your waifus can work for you to get some gold and other things. I showed you some cards with some fancy frames on them. Well, your cards can work for the materials to make those frames. Work permits are huge in this game and is definitely something you can get when you get a solid collection down. But that's a little bit more advanced than just for beginners. Wow, what a time, what a ride. I know I jammed a lot in there for 5 minutes. And that was how to play Karuta for beginners. And this will be probably the last Karuta video that I will be making. Maybe, I don't know, I have a solid Karuta scammer story if you're interested. But I will only make that video if a lot of people ask for it. Let's say 200 likes and I'll do it. If you are obsessed with Karuta content and are really interested in learning more about it, I recommend my good friend and fellow creator, Sea Salt. He goes really into the meat of Karuta and teaches you all the different secrets and tips. Be sure to look at his stuff, I will put his links all in the description down below. But if you like this video, you like anime recommendations, learning more about anime, then do I have a channel for you? It's me. It's this channel. But please support my channel by giving a like, a comment, subscribe even. Join my Discord server. As I said, if you want to play Karuta on it, you have to go to the roles tab. Otherwise, it's a normal community Discord server. But I do have to say, my server is probably the most wholesome place in this corner of the internet. But either way, please let me know your thoughts about Karuta. Are you a beginner? What's the best card that you've dropped so far? Have you lost sleep because of this game? Just let me know. It's not like I care or anything. You see these tabs on my monitors? Yeah, that'll happen to you. You'll join multiple servers and you're gonna wanna watch multiple servers. Who knows?